Do you have a friend that's been working on their art technique for 10 or so years? Do you want to be better than them without actually putting in any effort or dedication? Then we have the product for you. Introducing the InstaArtist Pen. Just put the tip to the paper and you will be drawing like a trained professional. Skip those embarrassing early art pieces and practice sketchbooks. Save on art supplies. Upstage your hardworking friends. This can all be yours for a single payment of $29.99. Call now or order online for your very own InstaArtist Pen.
Tribe, your source for the news and views around Clairemont High School.
She's Aaron Murphy, and I'm Caleb Schrader, and we've got the news for the week of October 19th, 2020.
It's getting close to Halloween. Caleb, are you decorating your house?
You know I am.
Well, let's get on with the show. On October 30th, grades will be due. These grades are really important because they will be the last grades you will get before we switch classes on November 2nd. Make sure you stay on top of your classes and don't procrastinate to do your work. Don't forget to constantly check PowerSchool in case there's a mistake. If you need extra credit or more time on your assignments, don't forget to ask your teachers for help. These few weeks can really impact your final grade, so don't give up and try your best.
The CHS Foundation is hosting a Halloween decoration contest with a prize for the winner and opportunities for those who vote to get prizes as well. Be sure to submit your address by October 27th if you want to enter. On October 28th through the 31st is when everyone will hit the road to view the Halloween displays from the safety of their own vehicle. Pick your favorite by 11 p.m. on Sunday, November 1st. To enter, view the address list and vote and go to www.chsfoundation.info.
Seniors, it's time for Counselor's Corner. Our updates this week include letters of recommendation. Mr. Ramirez reminds everyone to ask early. Remember the deadline for requesting letters of rec. Also, don't forget about the brag sheet. Now for your workshop calendar. Mark the dates next week for October 28th. That's when the CSU application workshop is. If you have any questions for state schools, you can find your answers in this workshop. It runs from 3 to 4. There's a Google form you will need to fill out in order to get the link. Also, on the 28th is a Cal Soap College Fair. This kind of sounds cool. Multiple colleges will set up during a 2-hour virtual tour where you can go in and out of booths as you like. You can engage with college admissions from the schools you want to know more about. Check out the website to register. It's hopin.to/events/Cal Soap Virtual. College Fair. Don't forget the dashes between the words, or ask Miss Victorino. On October 29th, it's time for the UC application workshop. This workshop will have a UC rep helping out along with Wahoopa. You need to fill out the Google Doc top to get your Zoom link again. Same time here as well from 3 to 4. And in November, there is a FAFSA workshop, so seniors, it's time to get going. I know the weather has been beautiful out lately, but you have to get this stuff done. Your next 4 years depend on it. Hey Chieftains, Miss Moore is hosting Making It Together with CHS every Wednesday at 3 on Zoom. Last week we made peanut butter chews. Join us this Wednesday for something new and fun. Check Mr. Williams' swag email for more details.
We want to see how you're carving your pumpkins. Email your pictures to Sparks and we'll put your pumpkins on our next show. We want to see what you did.
There are still clubs on campus. We can't meet in person, but we can still have virtual club meetings. If you have an interest in something and want to start a club, you should. Get the paperwork from Ms. Moore and email her. All you need is 4 club officers and a club advisor. It's good to have a teacher as your advisor. Contact Ms. Moore for details.
Keep your eyes peeled for Mr. Williams' weekly swag, and seniors, be on the lookout for any emails from your counselors. If you're not getting any emails, you need to update your information and get on that email list. Important letters of recommendation and scholarship opportunities are headed to your inbox soon.
The ASB Council is in order for the ASB students who have received positions this year. Congratulations to everybody here. Your ASB class president for this year is Allison Cunningham. The vice president for ASB is Lily Brady. Your ASB secretary is Isabella Mendoza. Your ASB treasurer is Heidi Amaro. Your ASB commissioner of events is Kiana Miller. The ASB commissioner of athletics is Emma Desani. ASB commissioner of student relations is Kristen Phillips. Your ASB commissioner of ambassadors is Ashley Garcia. Your class of 2021 president is Leilani Anderson. Your class of 22 president is Andrew Jeter, and your 23 president is Casey Harris. Class of 2024 president is Johnny Nguyen. As 2020 goes on, we're faced with another great loss. On October 6th, legendary guitarist Eddie Van Halen passed away after a long battle against cancer. The news of his death has left many friends and fans heartbroken, and many fellow artists have paid tribute to him. Howard Stern released an 8-minute long tribute video the next day discussing Van Halen's talent and influence. Stern even showed a guitar signed and given to him by Eddie to showcase the late guitarist's immense generosity. Van Halen's contributions to the music world have also gone far from unnoticed, with guitarist Jack White playing a guitar signed by Eddie on Saturday Night Live. But unsurprisingly, the most notable were the heartfelt messages from those who Van Halen was closest to. His son Wolfgang was the one who originally broke the news, and Van Halen's band members and family soon followed. But even after his death, Eddie Van Halen continues to influence all those who heard his guitar or watched him smile at the camera in a music video. His guitar playing touched an entire generation and forever changed the music that Gen X listened to. As long as fans emit his playing, smile along with him and listen to his music, he will live on.
Since there are no sports going on for us Chieftains, we'll be talking about sports outside of our school.
Thanks, Caleb.
Outside of our school, the NBA has wrapped up their season as the Los Angeles Lakers defeat the Miami Heat in a 6-game series. Usually professional sports championships are followed up by huge parades, but in the time of the pandemic, the Lakers will hold theirs until after COVID is over. SDSU football opens up their season on October 24th against what was supposed to be UNLV, but will be a new opponent due to UNLV having several positive tests. Other college football conferences, such as Powerhouse SEC, have begun their season already, but have run into COVID problems. Similar to college football, the NFL has had a very difficult time controlling the pandemic, as many teams have either had someone test positive or had their game rescheduled due to the opponent testing positive. If they don't get these problems under control, there will be a major rescheduling problem. In the MLB, the Dodgers swept the local San Diego Padres in the NLDS. Even though the Padres didn't win, close games and elevated emotions between the two teams throughout the year has sparked a rivalry that could be one of the biggest in sports years to come. The Dodgers have made it to the World Series by beating the Atlanta Braves in 7 games in the NLCS. The Tampa Bay Rays beat the Houston Astros in another 7-game series in the NLCS. The two pennant winners will face off in the World Series starting Tuesday, October 20th.
That's it for us. Heading back to you, Caleb, to close us out.
Thanks, Max. Chieftains, we'll make sure to keep you up to date on the sports world.
And that's it for our show. Make sure to keep it orange and blue.
See you next time on Clairemont Student News, and have a wonderful week.